I'm Sonia Savage, Alberta's new energy minister, and we're here in Vancouver to announce and to launch the Yes to TMX campaign in the Lower Mainland. I was in Ottawa yesterday announcing the Yes to TMX campaign in Ottawa to urge the federal government to get to a yes and to approve the pipeline on June 18th. So today in British Columbia, we launched the campaign to talk about all the benefits of TMX to British Columbia and to highlight the fact that you have the highest gasoline prices in all of North America, and we can help with that. Twinning Trans Mountain will greatly help to get the price at the pumps down. The gasoline is the highest price in British Columbia in entire North America, all of North America, not just in Canada, but in North America. And the restrictions and the apportionment on Trans Mountain Pipeline has greatly contributed to that. Most of the gasoline you get in Vancouver comes one way or another, either as gasoline or as crude oil to be refined in the Trans Mountain Pipeline. So having a greater supply will give you much needed relief at the pumps. We can't take any chances. Every day, every week, every month, this project is delayed, costs Canada's economy. It costs Alberta's economy, Canada's and British Columbia's economy. So we're taking nothing for granted. This project's been delayed over and over and over again. And June 18th, we don't want to see any delays from that, or we could lose an entire construction season on Trans Mountain, and losing a construction season would be absolutely devastating. I think the best way to do is to take your message right to the heart of the opposition. It's a bold thing to do, but take that message to the very heart of the opposition. And because this project is for the benefit of the entire country, the jobs it creates, the uptick to the economy, the municipal taxes, the government revenues from this project, not to mention the relief at the pumps affects every single person. So taking it to the heart of the opposition, we get our message out. And what we're really asking British Columbians to do, and the vast majority of British Columbians actually support the pipeline, as does the majority of Canadians, but we're asking British Columbians to stand with Albertans, to stand with fellow Canadians, and ask the Premier to say yes to Trans Mountain. Tell the federal government to say yes to Trans Mountain, and to ask the Premier to stop any obstructionist strategies to block the pipeline. The world's demand, the global demand for oil and gas is not decreasing. In fact, it's going up. We believe that Albertan oil, Canadian oil, has the highest environmental standards, the highest standards in health and labor and ethical standards of any oil anywhere in the world. So if we're not producing it in Alberta and delivering it to the world, some other country is going to be doing it. It'll be the United States, it'll be the Middle Eastern, that all do not have the same high ethical and environmental standards that we are. So we're the best, the most environmentally friendly supplier of oil in the entire world.
What in total are you spending on this?
It's about $1.1 million here in the Lower Mainland of British Columbia, and that's going to include digital. It includes print ads, radio. It includes posters and billboards in restaurants, and it includes the digital billboards that we displayed and launched this morning. This is a limited campaign for the duration between now and when Trans Mountain is approved, which we are hoping won't be kicked down the road from June 18th. So this is a limited term campaign, but this is the type of things you'll see coming out of the war room once we have it staffed and set up and its mandate going. We want British Columbians to know and understand and to support the project. So we just think there'll be greater public awareness of this, and when people understand the facts, it's much easier to support something. This is an Alberta message, this is a Canadian message. The previous government also did a tremendous amount of advertisement. This is something it's not partisan at all. We believe the majority of British Columbians, and we've seen polls, that they support this project and want it to proceed. It's a project for the national unity. So we've had good response. When I speak to British Columbians, the majority of them support this project. Every single poll that's been done on the project comes out the same. The majority of Canadians, including the majority of British Columbians, support the project.